Daughter of the late Cebu Vice-Governor Gregorio Sanchez, Ms. Gigi Sanchez. Ms. Sanchez is now a complaining witness in a case filed by her father against Garcia before he passed away in 2011. Ms. Sanchez, good morning.
Yeah, good morning, Ron. Good morning to everyone, ANC.
Ms. Sanchez, we've been able to talk to suspended Governor Gwen Garcia. We've also been able to talk to Acting Governor Agnes Magpale. But we want to know your thoughts about the situation in Cebu and what your family is feeling right now.
Yeah, like right now, since the CA did not issue a temporary restraining order ex parte as what they have requested, but instead the CA wanted an investigative hearing or a hearing on January 10. We will be there, and my lawyers will also be there in case we need to comment. And I'm happy about the result because this is due process to me.
Okay, so you're happy that there was no TRO, but a hearing for the TRO?
Yes, I'm happy that they were not given the TRO ex parte that they expected, but instead the CA wanted a hearing, an oral argument for both camps.
Mm-hmm. But with Governor Gwen Garcia not stepping down or not being, not following the suspension order and still staying at the Capitol, how do you feel about that? And what has your family said about it?
Yeah, to me, this is still another case of abuse of authority, just like what she did to my late father, sometime 2007, 8, 9, 10. It was an ongoing abuse of authority, which really prompted our family to stand for it. And her defiance of the law, to me, is still another abuse of authority.
Okay, Ms. Sanchez, you are described as a complaining witness. What exactly is a complaining witness? Are you officially party to the complaint against Governor Gwen Garcia?
No. In my father's three terms, I have not been in any way connected to the Capitol because I'm a chemical engineer and mm-hmm. I've been managing our business. But my simple participation there for the case is to gather the evidences because this case was filed by my father sometime October 10, 2010. Mm-hmm. But unfortunately, he died April 29, 2011. And then the hearing started July. So he left several documents in our family home. And there were several scribbled notes in relation to this case. Now, I spoke to our lawyers and said that my simple participation is to gather the evidence because this is simply a documentary case. This is simply a case where you present documents as the evidence, not necessarily me having to be there at that instance.
And with the...
So I simply gathered evidence, documentary evidence, to prove the grave abuse of authority.
Okay, so you're just gathering evidence but not officially party to the complaint against Governor Gwen Garcia.
No, I'm considered as complaining witness, wherein the base evidence that I have gathered, which were certified true copies coming from the Capitol, were accepted because these are evidence mm-hmm. related to the case.
Mm-hmm. Okay, being a complaining witness, and you have gathered all the evidence against Governor Gwen Garcia. Now, how do you react to the Garcia camp saying that this is just something that's politically motivated, and then this is nothing but a power grab in Cebu?
No, my family simply sees this not politically motivated because we were following due process. In fact, it's 2 years ago. We diligently followed every step of the way. And in fact, I would like to stress the lawyer or the lead counsel for this particular case is her daughter. It's the governor's daughter, attorney Christina Frasco. So there's no way they were given ample time to present their own evidence, their witnesses, and we simply followed every bit of it. So it's kind of strange for me now for them to say not due process was given to them. And all this, it's simply complicated because it's not what it actually was. And my father filed this 2 years ago. He was still alive. And when it's a power grab, I think the power grab there stems from her because the mandate is not anymore with her. It's with Acting Governor Agnes Magpale.
Okay. Ms. Gigi, I want to ask you first, have you been employed by the Capitol before when your father was still Vice Governor or even with Vice Governor Agnes Magpale taking over?
During my father's term, I was not in any way connected to the Capitol. I was not a consultant or whatever. But after my father died, mm-hmm. I simply had to do it on my own, get whatever documents needed. And unfortunately, those Capitol heads were not cooperative at the time. 2 years ago, they were really scared of the governor. But I had to be determined. It's simply a determination of a daughter seeing a grieving father at the time. So I had to be there time and again just to get these documents. But as far as being a consultant, no, I'm not a consultant of my father. But there was a request from Vice Governor Agnes Magpale before for me to be a consultant on organic farming, since mm-hmm. that is my main line. Mm-hmm. But that was also like 2 months, just 2 months in the making. So it was not really a active participation in this particular case. Nothing to do with this case.
And it was just connected to organic farming?
Yes. The reason why I was asked to be a consultant of Agnes Magpale was for the organic farming in the mountain barangay.
And I believe you also have a special arrangement with the payment as a consultant. How much did you earn as a consultant then?
Unfortunately, no. It's personal, not in any way related to the Capitol. It was for her to get an update of the methods, new methods of organic farming.
Okay, so there
was 1 peso a year. It was 1 peso a year.
So you just received 1 peso a year, but you only worked for 2 months as a consultant on organic farming under mm-hmm. Vice Governor Agnes Magpale.
Yes, that was very recently.
Okay, we've also gathered reports that Governor Gwen Garcia opposed your hiring as a consultant, and we want to clarify if it was during the term of your father as Vice Governor or during Ms. Magpale's term as Vice Governor. Is there any...
If my memory serves me right, it was sometime August to September.
August 2012, but you did hear of that report that Governor Gwen Garcia opposed your hiring as a consultant?
Yes, she did not want that to happen, but instead of 1 peso a year, so the Vice Governor just hired me as a personal consultant. She wanted to be abreast with organic farming for the mountain barangay.
Do you know the reason why she opposed your hiring as a consultant?
I really have no idea. Perhaps I do not know. I do not know why she opposed to that. When in fact there was nothing, no cost to the province. Just 1 peso a year.
Mm-hmm. And we also want to clarify that this is not part of the complaint. You not being accepted as a consultant of the Capitol, not being hired by the Capitol as a consultant. Because the basis of the complaint of your father is the holding of the budget, which affects the budget for the consultants that were being hired by the Vice Governor. You were not included in that.
No, I was not. For the 3 terms of my father, I was not in any way a consultant to his office. I was not in any way connected to the Capitol.
Okay, thank you very much for clarifying that. We want to know, ma'am, how was the relationship between Governor Gwen Garcia and Vice Governor Gregorio Sanchez before? Were they close at any point, or was it just official business between the two?
It was really difficult because the first term of my dad, they were they had several differences. One, if I may cite, if you please allow me to cite, my father was he was not for the purchase of the Balili property. This is the purchase of the underwater property that the governor did, and my father was really vehement in his office. He didn't want that to happen, but since he was alone at the time, it was carried out. And this is one of the reasons why they had the risks. And also another one is, since my father is a constructor, he's a civil engineer, mm-hmm. about the CICC, he had officers shown to the cost. of the CICC. And these were mounting up, these were building to the extent that I should say the governor wanted to put a CCTV camera in his office just to monitor who are the mayors coming in and out of his office, that in the event these mayors come in and out of his office, they will also be taken out. I mean, the vehicles will also be taken away from them. This is evident because it really happened. Vehicles of those mayors who were allied or were friends with my dad, the vehicles issued to them were also taken away. And I could not imagine why she wanted to resort to putting a CCTV camera to a vice governor's office, which is also equally given the mandate of the people to serve. And these are one of the reasons that my father really complained. And as the head of the legislative department, they wanted a caucus, but there were just certain reasons that the governor would insist to strip him away of anything. And if I may just elaborate, I could say that even the table that he is sitting, probably in one way or another, the governor also wanted to take that away, getting away the security guard that was assigned to my dad. These were not even written on the case.
The CCTV cameras, were they installed eventually?
How's that again?
Were the CCTV cameras installed eventually? Or was it just a plan?
It was a plan, but then my dad really said, this is foul. This is not due. He doesn't deserve it. So they were not able to install it right then and there, but they were monitored. He was monitored every move he makes. So it was really unfortunate. And one of the reasons my father filed this during his last term, if I may be allowed to stress, is that he simply wanted the separation of powers between executive and legislative be clarified. And he also had the intention, whoever sits as the vice governor after his term, be treated fairly, and whatever happened to him should not happen again to any other vice governor in the land.
Okay, Ms. Sanchez, what are your plans now? Are you planning to make, or have you made an appeal to the national government to fully implement a suspension order and have Governor Gwen Garcia step down from the Capitol or step out of the Capitol, even though the Court of Appeals has already set a hearing on Governor Gwen Garcia's petition?
I would like to politely ask her to please abide by the mandate of the Office of the President, and this is according to the law. Her being a public official is also mandated to follow the rules. And, you know, it's an example that everyone should look up to her. We're not saying that she did not do anything, any good thing in her three terms of office, but we are simply saying that there was an offense done. So in a spirit of accountability, the governor did something, and she has to pay for it. And eventually, please, she should not hamper the operations of the Capitol, because all the other mayors are already complaining because there are some services that may not be delivered if she keeps on this drama at the Capitol.
Ms. Sanchez, do you have any political plans? Are you running for office in the upcoming elections?
Yeah, it's the first time I've heeded the call. At least it's from my mom. She wanted me to also try to give it a shot of what my father has started. And at the same time, there are certain other projects that my father left out, which were very important to the province of Cebu, which was also something that the governor blocked. It was the project that my father really wanted to give for the province of Cebu. This was called Trans Actual Highway. It's a very big highway that would decongest the city and at the same time develop the mountain barangays. And this is one of the projects that I would like to continue.
Okay, Ms. Gigi Sanchez, complaining witness to the case against Governor Gwen Garcia, thank you very much for talking to us this morning.
Much.